Given the recent confusion in the e-commerce space regarding the deliverability requirements, coming this February, I'm here to guide you step by step through this process. I will not be covering what and why are these changes coming. But if you're new to this, make sure to watch this video, the link is in the description, to get yourself up to speed. Now in this walkthrough, I will assume that you already have these required prerequisites. Number 1, an Omnisend account. Number 2, an e-commerce store hosted on a custom domain. Number 3, access to your hosting dashboard for DNS record management. If you do not meet at least one of these requirements, we have multiple guides in the description that could help you with that. And now for the part you came here for. In this tutorial, I have already created my own store called Aglutescorata on aglutescorata.lt domain, and I already have an email account called info@aglutescorata.lt, which I will be using for sending our future communications to my customers. So this is my demo store that I have created on Shopify that's hosted on aglutescorata.lt. So let's go into the Omnisend dashboard and see what we have to do. As you can see, there is this red banner right above over there, and it's asking us to view the action. So let's go ahead and do that. That's very crucial, that's very important. So the first step is to add and authenticate customer sender's domain. So let's go ahead and click on this button and see where it takes us. It takes us right into the sender domain page in our settings. So if we click over here, we are asked to enter our domain name. Now this is the website that your e-commerce store is hosted on. In my case, it would be aglutescorata.lt. I enter the domain name and I click on continue. Now, once that's done, I am transferred to the SPF, DKIM and DMARC verification process, where I will just need to copy and paste it into my DNS provider's dashboard. If you're curious to know what exactly do these letters stand for, you can click right over here to learn more about these specific records, or I will just leave it the link in the description. So let's go through each of these steps one by one. First of all, we need to copy the value that's given over here under the SPF. Let's copy that and let's go to our hosting page. Now, in my case, I am using Hostinger as my hosting website to host aglutescorata.lt over here, as you can see. So I'm just gonna go ahead and manage that. Once I'm transferred to the domains page, I can just click on DNS name servers. Now, of course, every dashboard is not the same, so it might look different on your end, but I'm just gonna show this as an example. And here we can manage the DNS records. This is exactly what we need, and this is exactly what we're going to do. So what you do is add a TXT record type, TXT. It's always gonna be TXT, and in the name, instead of using the at symbol, you're going to have to enter your custom domain. aglutescorata.lt. And in the value field, you just paste whatever you copied on our website. There you go. As for the TTL, if you know exactly what you're doing and you feel comfortable doing it, feel free to adjust it to your liking. But in this case, I would just leave it as the default. And default in my case is 14400. Now, I know that every hosting website is different, so I'm gonna try and find some examples online and point you in the right direction. Hello, future me.
Hey there, me. I do not have access to other hosting services, but I managed to locate some information about them. So this is the GoDaddy dashboard. It looks not too unusual to what we've already seen on hostinger.lt, with similarly named fields all across the board. To add a TXT record here, you would need to navigate to DNS settings page, click add right here, and enter the details as my past self already shown. Notice that instead of TTL requiring a numeric value, you can simply keep it as default. Namecheap looks similar, with some slight changes. Like the name field, as we've seen before, is called host here, but it does not change anything and it serves the same purpose. To add a TXT record here, simply click on add new record right here and then paste everything as usual. Google Domains keeps it simple, maybe even too simple to understand for beginners. So the first field you would see here would be the name field. The second one would be type. Notice how they switched places. In the third place, we have a TTL field. And the last one is the value field, which also conveniently switched places with the rest. Don't let these context texts and different layout confuse you. They are there to give you an idea of what should go there, but don't necessarily name exactly what is expected for beginners. So hopefully I was able to clear that up for you. As you can see, most of them share a lot of similarities with some exceptions, but you should be able to get a grasp of it quite quickly. Back to you, Pass Me.
Let's add the record. and let's see if that worked. Now you can just do it one by one, DKIM, DMARC, etc., and then verify all of them. But in this case, let's just verify the first one. Verify. As you can see, SPF record was added successfully. That's a success. And since we did nothing in DKIM and DMARC, the records were not found yet. So let's fix that. Now, another thing to note is that verification process might take up to 24 hours, which is rare, but it happens. So if it doesn't work right away, don't worry, just give it a little bit of time and it might show up as verified a bit later. In my case, it was pretty instantaneous. So let's copy the DKIM name. Let's copy that, go to the hosting site. Again, TXT record type, name, as we copied, go back here, copy the value, enter the value. TTL as is, add record. And finally, DMARC. Copy DMARC, add TXT, add it here, DMARC, boom, add record. And there we go. Now we have added all of the required records to our hosting site, so let's see if it works on Omnisend side. Verify records, and everything was successfully activated. Let's just go to the sender's email address, and as you can see, my current email addresses do not correctly correspond with the domain that I'm running my e-commerce store on. They all end in @omnisend.com. What I need is @aglutescarota.lt, my store name. So let's go ahead and add that. And there we go. As you can see, it's still unverified, but no worries. Let's just click on verify over here and I will be sent a verification email in my inbox. And 30 seconds later, I am backed with a verified email because I clicked the link in my inbox. And now, as you can see, the red banner above indicates that 2 out of 3 steps are already done. So let's view the last one. Now, in this final step, you need to select if you want to let Omnisend assign future campaign and automation sending to this specific domain that you have currently set up, or would you prefer to do it later or yourself or adjust it accordingly. We highly recommend the first option because it's the easiest and it's gonna make sure that you're up and running in no time. So let's go ahead and select the yes I want recommended. Finish it, and now the red scary banner is gone and you are ready for the future. That wasn't so scary. And there you go. Hopefully you were able to take away something new and prepare for the changes ahead of us all. If you are stuck, again, we have multiple helpful guides in the description and our awesome 24/7 support team is ready to help you any time of the day. Thank you for your trust and Godspeed.